There is emotion, yet I choose peace. There is passion, yet I choose serenity. There is chaos, yet I choose harmony. There is ignorance, yet I choose knowledge. There is death, yet I choose the Force. This is a coping card that I made for myself as Ahsoka was coming out, because Ahsoka to me is one of those Jedi. Ahsoka to me is one of the Jedi who exemplifies what it means to be a Jedi, even if she doesn't consider herself one. I won't go into too many spoilers regarding the Ahsoka series, but there might be some minor spoilers here and there, so you have been warned. But overall, I found it to be a really great series, and though I am reserving judgment until the series is fully complete, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in. So what I'm painting is Rosario Dawson's Ahsoka. I took this image from one of the Vanity Fair magazine shots and decided to expand upon it, giving her the vibe of fighting stormtroopers in a very forested area. I thought about doing Corvus, but I liked the purple background so much that initially I had decided to keep it. The purple background would get replaced with a much darker background to help complement her lightsabers. I still really enjoyed this process. One of the things that I don't think does get talked about the most regarding Ahsoka is how she left the Jedi Order upon feeling that she was gaslit by them, who, at first, for context, for those who don't know, at first she was accused of vandalizing and murdering a Republic, the Jedi Temple, and a Republic civilian, but it later turned out to actually be her best friend, a fellow Jedi Knight, who was very dissatisfied with how the Republic and the Jedi were raging and continuing the Clone Wars rather than stopping it. Ahsoka, I think leaving the Jedi Order was probably one of the best ways that she could stand up for herself at that time and also make the Jedi realize, especially Jedi like Anakin, Mace Windu, and even Kenobi, and Yoda as well, realize how much pain they have done through all their actions. And for a long time, that was Ahsoka's story. She kind of vanished, and in a way, I think it's almost kind of fitting that she quote-unquote did vanish for some time, because it really sold into the idea of her going into, like, exile and finding her own path away from the Skywalker saga. Having watched Rebels and read the Ahsoka book, as well as having watched Clone Wars Season 7, we've seen Ahsoka return, and she makes her live-action debut in The Mandalorian. While some people were a little dissatisfied with this version of Ahsoka, we have to remember that Ahsoka has witnessed the fall of the Republic, the fall of her master, whom she almost considered to be a brother figure, as well as the fall of the Jedi Order, and has been put into a role of being a sort of guerrilla fighter during Rebels, and in The Mandalorian, she's kind of like described as a wandering Ronin. Because it looks like she's on her own and disconnected from Luke Skywalker and the New Republic, despite still have maintaining ties with them. Ahsoka, I'd say, is also on, like, her personal mission as well to stop Grand Admiral Thrawn. And what I like about that is that it kind of goes to show how, like, in a world as big as Star Wars, you have the potential to tell a lot of stories and a lot of, like, and you have the potential to tell a lot of stories and to explore characters outside of the Skywalker saga. And that's something I hope Star Wars does continue to expand on in the future, because I think right now that is their strength. And the Ahsoka series, it kind of surrounds this journey of healing and Ahsoka embracing herself. She starts out as this sort of, like, very distant, stoic master who's very stern and a little brash and kind of reserved as well. Far from the Ahsoka we knew and loved. Then an event happens where Ahsoka goes through some sort of a metaphorical rebirth. We see her kind of like question like her master's teachings, you know, is all I will ever be taught for is just for war. And what I really liked about the Ahsoka series was that it depicts the reality that Ahsoka, as well as many other Jedi, were child soldiers, essentially. And to another extent, one could even consider the clones child soldiers, since their aging has been accelerated, but each of them in the books, despite being a quote-unquote adult, were actually each 10 years old. In terms of not so much biological age, but more like the time they've been alive. And Ahsoka does have this chance to, like, as she's exploring these visions, give in to the dark side and take vengeance upon someone who had wronged her and someone who, like, fell to the dark side. But as she does, you also see her eyes turn yellow, just as her opponents, but she then stops and throws away the lightsaber, kind of in a similar way to Luke, where he then says that she chooses to live, which I believe is also a homage not only to what Luke says about, like, not falling to the dark side, but is also a homage to the first Tales of the Jedi story, in which it was titled Life and Death. And the theme of life and death was also explored in that, where Ahsoka's mother takes her on a hunting mission. They hunt and kill an animal, and Ahsoka's mother, like, explains the whole point of life and death. And in passing that test, Ahsoka shows that, like, she can choose life without needing to, like, give in to, like, the death of others or kill others. And I think moving forward, what Star Wars is going to explore, especially with new projects like Rey's Jedi Order, which I am super excited about, because I love the sequel cast, especially Rey, is I think it explores what it means to be a Jedi, or what would a new Jedi Order look like. And I think what a new Jedi Order is going to be is it's going to be full of a lot of, like, unorthodox Jedi, or Jedi who kind of who do their own thing, have their own belief systems, have their own fighting styles and vibes, kind of akin to what we see in the High Republic, where you have Jedi with light whips, Jedi who customize their robes and gear, and even Jedi who sometimes bend and outright break the Jedi rules because they are caught in the middle of a rough decision to make, or because it's just flat out they're human, as opposed to the prequel Jedi, which, despite being awesome in their own way, I do feel like the prequel Jedi also highlight why the Jedi Order was starting to fail. And I think moving forward, like, Ahsoka might be the first of these, like, new Jedi. And we already see it in Ezra and Sabine, whereas Sabine is not as Force-sensitive as others, but we do see that Ahsoka has taken her on as an apprentice, and she still fights in Mandalorian armor while wielding a saber. We even see Ezra, who has a history of, like, being a rather quote-unquote unorthodox Jedi, having a blaster-lightsaber hybrid in Rebels as a Padawan. And then later on, as he's fighting Thrawn, choosing to forgo the lightsaber and just purely use the Force. Aside from that, that's all I wanted to talk about. The future does look bright for Star Wars, and I'm really happy to see that this character that I've known and loved for over 10 years is on a very incredible journey, and I can't wait to see where it goes next. Thank you for watching the Speedpaint, and have a good evening, and be sure to check out my other Speedpaints as well.